If you are a healthy adult male, then you probably think that ship battles are pretty cool and kind of classy. Starhammer is here to deliver on that fantasy, but in space. So who am I to say no? Let us start by setting the record straight on what Starhammer is and is not. Starhammer is not a game where you roam around a huge galaxy living out your space fantasy. Starhammer is a game about space battles, and there is a campaign consisting of a number of space battles. Expect anything else and you will be disappointed. The story is set on a distant planet. Human colonists arrived there to settle down, but they got a surprise attack by space bugs. Admiral Dice managed to push them back into space and became a hero to the population. And years later, you play as his daughter, Valerian dies, and I'm sure you can guess what is going to happen next. The story and setting is alright, and there is some nice chats between the crew members on your flagship. Depending on how you play and which missions you choose, the story will play out differently. It is an fun idea, but it's not always clear how the choice you make will affect the story, and the crew members won't try to persuade you to pick any certain choice. Besides choosing missions in the campaign view, you can also level up your characters and order replacement ships. To me, this is the biggest missed opportunity in the game. Your crew members level up, but it's so basic that it's barely there. Your ships can level up as well, but it's nothing more than small bonuses to some stats. I would expect to be able to upgrade the ships in interesting ways, but there is nothing there. You also can't order more ammo mid-chapter, and since you have no idea how long a chapter will be, this can put you in really bad situations, where you have to choose between either having a really bad time or replaying a previous mission. Overall, this part of the game is a big letdown, and to some extent it is just a glorified mission select screen, and I would have liked it to be so much more. The main part of this game is the combat. So how does it work? Well, the battles take place in real time, but you get to plan the action one time chunk at a time. Think about Frozen Synapse, for example. So you plan out the action of your ships in the planning phase, and then you hit the go button, and you will see the outcome of your plans in the next seconds. I like this system, and it allows you to relax and plan out your actions, while still see the action take place in real time. And as you can't pause every millisecond, it also reduces the amount of micromanagement, which otherwise would kill me in a game like this. There are some problems though. Missiles can really hurt your ships, and to stop these missiles you need to deploy counter missiles. With this system here, there is a lot of guesswork involved, as you often have to pre-deploy the counter missiles before the enemies have fired the actual missiles. In each battle, you will only have a handful of ships, and for each ship you can divide the energy into shields, weapons and engines, and you can further divide how the shield energy should be split in the six directions. Some ships will have further abilities like missiles, counter missiles and drones, but the core of the combat is to navigate this 3D space with your ships and position yourself in a good way and to spend your energy wisely. I like this system, and there is an appropriate amount of micromanagement without it going overboard. The planning phase also looks really cool. I might be contradicting myself, but it would have been cool to have some missions at least with the larger forces available. At least it would be good for the sake of variety. Variety is a problem in this game, as there is only two factions and very few ships you can actually control. There are a lot of repetitive fights, and the maps can also be very similar to each other. You can make fun of me if you want for wanting varied space maps, but that's what I want. Let's mention some other nitpicks before moving on to the big one. Some fights can be a clusterfuck, and it can be very hard to keep track of asteroids in a three-dimensional space, and the UI is supposed to warn you, but I often collided with objects despite the UI telling me that the route was safe. And let's not even talk about space mines. The big drawback for me though, with this game, are the space bugs. I just don't like them. You will fight a bunch of different space bugs in this game, and there is a lot of nonsense in this faction. How about the space bug that spam mines and can magically heal other nearby space bugs? How about big space bugs that are constantly spawning minor space bugs? I just do not like this faction, and I have no problem admitting to being a bit butthurt as I had to replay the last mission over and over again to beat it. I'm sure that it will be a breeze for you, but I'm a low IQ individual and I managed to use up all my missiles in the previous mission, which I was dumb enough to think was the last one. After spending hours just banging my head against this wall, I managed to come up with a sideways turtle formation, and through endless cheesing I managed to win the mission. But it left me with a bad taste in my mouth. It took me 15 hours to complete the game. To conclude, Starhammer is a fun enough game, but it has problems and it could be much more than it is today. I would recommend it to people interested in the genre, but it's certainly not for everyone.